Welcome to Beacon High School online video. Today we are going to learn about animal life. Students, to learn about the animal life, first we have to understand about habitat and adaptation. Now, what is habitat? Habitat is the place or environment in which an animal or plant lives naturally. Air, land, and water are the habitats for different kinds of animals. These places have different conditions of climate, temperature, and availability of food and water. Now, animals living in a habitat, they adapt themselves in many ways to survive in the given environment. Now, what is environment? It is a surrounding of an animal in which it lives. What are adaptation? An adaptation is a change in an animal that helps them to survive in its environment. For example, polar bears have very thick fur and fat on their body. So to protect them from severe cold conditions, these fur and fat on their body help them to survive in that given environment. Animals can be big, small, or microscopic. They are found everywhere on the earth. They can be found in very hot or very cold regions that help them to support their life. Different animals have different adaptations, and they are different organs for breathing. They have different feeding habits. They have different body movements, and their body coverings also gives an advantage to survive in the given environment. Let us study what are the different organs present in animals for breathing. We all know that all animal beings breathe in oxygen and give out carbon dioxide. Breathing is essential for survival. Different animals living in different habitats have different organs for breathing that suit their environment. The first one is the lungs. Birds, mammals, and reptiles, they breathe with the help of the lungs. All mammals, including human beings, breathe through the nose that enters into the body, and then air is carried to the lungs. The next one is the gills. Animals like fish, crabs, and prawns that live in water breathe through the gills. Now, what are gills? Gills are feathery organs that is enclosed in the pouches present on each side of the head of the animals. Gills absorb the dissolved oxygen present in water. The next organ is the spiracles. Insect like flies, mosquitoes, and butterflies breathe through air holes present in their body. These air holes are called spiracles. The next is the skin. Animals like earthworm, they breathe through their body surface or skin. We also know that amphibians like frogs, they also breathe through both lungs and the skin. All animals need food to live. Different animals have different food habits. For example, some bite and chew food, some suck up liquid or dissolved food, while others animals, they swallow the solid food as a whole. Let us study about the feeding habits in birds. We know that bird uses their beaks for eating, and their beaks are suited so that they can catch the kind of food they eat. For example, owls have very small hooked beaks because they eat small animals. Woodpecker has chisel shaped beak that help them to drilling into trees for insect. Parrot have curved and hooked beaks so that help them to eat the fruit and nut. Hen have very small beak that help them to eat seeds and grain. Whereas eagle have large hooked beaks that help them to ripping the flesh from their prey. Next is the type of teeth. The type of teeth in an animal also depends on the type of food they eat. For example, herbivores. Herbivores or plant-eating animals have blunt teeth in front for biting and flat, broad, grinding teeth at the back of the mouth for chewing. The next is the carnivores. Carnivores are flesh-eating animals, so they have pointed tearing teeth called canines. They use this to tear the flesh. The next is the rodents. Rodents have front teeth that uses to bite and nibble their food. Now, what is nibble? Nibble means taking small bite of the food. Squirrels, rats, and mice are all rodents. They nibble grains, nuts, and fruits. Next is the butterfly. Butterfly sucks its food through a tube-like mouth part called proboscis. There are some animals like lizards. They use their tongue to catch an insect. The next is the omnivores. Omnivores are those animals who eat both plant and animals. So they have the front teeth for tearing and biting and the molar teeth for chewing. Now a question arises, why animals move? Animals move around for various reasons, to find food, to escape or to protect from the predators or to find a mate. They also move to find suitable environmental conditions that is needed for their survival and breeding. Breeding means producing the offspring. First is the land animals. Land animals move in many different ways. Many animals like kangaroo, cheetah, hippopotamus, elephant, tiger, lion, rabbit, they can walk, run, leap, or hop. Animals who are not having the limbs, they slither. For example, snakes. Slither means moving smoothly over the surface. Some, like worms and bugs, crawl on the surface. Water animals. Animals that live in water, for example, shark and fish, have fins and tails that help them to move. Frogs and ducks have webbed feet that help them in swimming. Sea mammals like whale and dolphin have flippers that help them for movement. Aerial animals. Animals that fly using wings are known as aerial animals. Birds have wings that is covered with feathers. Wings is used for lifting and steering. Their tails also help them to steer. Bats are mammals that can fly, but their wings are not made of feathers. Instead, they are stretched skin covering bony hand-like part of the body. The next adaptation in the animal is body covering. Different animals have different body coverings which help them to survive in their environment. The first is the scales. Bodies of fishes, snakes, crocodile, and lizards are covered with the scales. These help prevent water loss from their body. Fishes are covered with the overlapping scales that are waterproof. The next adaptation in body covering is shell. Many animals such as tortoise, snails and turtles, they are protected by hard shell. When these animals sense danger, they withdraw their head and feet into the shell. Fur. Sheep and polar bear have wool or fur that protects them from the cold climate that keep them warm. Next adaptation is the spines. The body of porcupine and echidna are covered with sharp spines that help them to protect themselves from their enemies. Next is the feathers. The bodies of the birds are covered with feathers that help them to fly and also to keep them warm. The next adaptation is camouflage. The body coverings of some animals matches with their surrounding. It makes the animals hard to spot and helps them to protect themselves from their enemies. This ability is called camouflage. Some predators also camouflage so that their prey cannot see them easily. For example, a walking stick insect looks like a stem, and chameleon also shows the camouflage. Migration. Migration is a behavioral adaptation. It is a periodic mass movement of animals, means that animals in a group move from one place to another over large distance in response to seasonal change. For example, animals move from colder region to warmer region to survive. Now, what are the reasons for migration? The reasons for migration are unfavorable seasonal condition, shortage of food and water, and breeding. Due to unfavorable seasonal conditions, animals face shortage of food and water, and the weather condition is also not suitable for breeding. So, to find a place with enough food, water, and suitable weather, they migrate from one place to another. Now, example is Arctic tern. Arctic tern is famous for its migration. It flies from Arctic region to the Antarctic and back again each year. The next is the Siberian crane. Siberian crane are mostly found in Russia and Siberia. But in winter season, they in search of warmer climate, they travel to a number of Southeast Asian countries including India. So today, we all have learnt about the adaptation in animals like body coverings, movement, migration, feeding habits, and different breathing organs present in animals.